afternoon, Dr. Rob. I'm a reporter of the magazine, and today I want to give you an interview with it.
Okay.
Let's start.
Yeah.
The first question is, as an advisor of this magazine, what hopes do you have for us?
Well, what I would hope that you would do with this magazine is learn how to work together and to produce something that has some good quality and produce something that we can be proud to give to your parents to show them what you do in this school.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Yes. Next, second question is, which ideas or thoughts should be included in this magazine to your mind? And would you please shed some light on it?
Yeah, well, again, I don't want to give you my ideas. I want the ideas to come from the students so that the students have the experience of creating this magazine. So what we would like to see in the magazine, or what I think you should put in the magazine, are good images of the school, and the interesting things that you've been doing the whole year. Not just, oh, we do lots of homework, or, you know, we are very tired all the time, but just things that are really interesting for you, and that to show your parents, you know, that how hard you work. You know, you all have a dream that you want to go to university, so.
Okay, the last question is, the title of this magazine is We. So what do you think are the differences between us and your former students, and what do you think of us?
Well, I think We is a very good good title because you know, you're all working together, and the story is going to be about the whole group, the whole year 11 group. So yeah, you are a We. And I think you know, the difference between students in the Chinese school and an English school, it's not a lot of difference. That once you understand what you want to do and you get excited about doing it, then people, I think some people try very hard to make that successful. And if we can make our teaching, you know, as a teacher, you really want your students to be involved in doing something and thinking for themselves, not just being told what to do all the time by the teacher, you know, do this, do this, do this. So I'm, you know, very happy with what's going on. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Okay.
I'm a reporter of this magazine, and today I want to give you an interview with it. Can I start? Okay.
It's my biggest pleasure to accept something.
Okay. Now, we are working on the creation of the magazine. So, what expectations do you have for us?
Okay, first of all, I'm not an expert in terms of journalism, and neither am I a newspaper editor. So, what I only can give you are some general guiding principles, which I hope can facilitate the process of creating this beautiful, wonderful, brilliant magazine. First of all, a good magazine should have a good focus coupled with very rich and detailed information, because your middle school students, every day you're just like birds cooped up in a small cage. You don't have a lot of freedom, so every day you're just having classes and going to the canteen to have breakfast and lunch and dinner. And yeah, it's a very boring life, so I think the focus of the magazine should be on the campus life. You are enjoying or you're suffering every day. Also, you can shed some light on the aspects of the school life, which in your eyes are very colorful, and very vivid, and quite charming.
Yeah, the second question is, which ideas or thoughts should be included in this magazine to your mind? And would you please share some light on it?
I mean, some ideas and thoughts.
Yes, yeah.
I think a good magazine should be truthful and should be very close to real life. Okay. Right now, you're dealing with friends and classmates, and you're talking with teachers every day. So I think you can just put some perspectives on the school life you're having every day. Also, we can talk about the close mutual relationships you're having with the teachers, with the classmates, and things like that. And number two, I think a good magazine or a journalistic publication should be objective. So it should be based on facts and the life stories of real people in real life, in real world.
Yeah. Also, the last question is, the title of this magazine is We. So what do you think about the difference between us and your former students, and what do you think of us?
Okay, well, it's very interesting, but also very broad question.
Yeah.
I've been working here at Dongshan's International Department for almost 2 years and a half. So this is almost the third year I have been here. And I think I've got very mixed feelings here. I enjoy the beautiful campus, the beautiful environment. I enjoy teaching the wonderful, lovely kids. If you really want me to make some comparisons and draw contrasts between you and the students that I've taught in the past, I think first of all, there are some similarities. You are both very outgoing, very charming, very intelligent, and also full of a big sense of humor, okay? Mm-hmm. But I think the students in the past that I've taught, they are more serious, and perhaps they look very bookish, and they spend many, many hours every day studying and reading books, but also spend a lot of time outside, taking classes and training camps. But I think you are closer to the teachers here, and closer to the friends and classmates here. I think you have a more cohesive and collaborative relationship with both the students and the teachers. So I believe both the students that I've taught in the past and the current students that I'm teaching right now, all of you must have a brilliant, bright, hopeful, and promising future.
Thank
That's
you.
All I want to say. Thank you.
You
indeed.